Why do you allow the devil to use you? Children are fragile. Hi guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. It is your girl Lollydi, YouTuber based in the United Kingdom. Talk about lifestyle, faith and everything that you can relate with. If you are joining for the first time, please do well to subscribe to the channel. If you are an old subscriber, thank you so much for always coming back to watch my videos. Having said that, now to the video of the moment. This whole thing has been trending. I need to talk about it. Children are supposed to be protected as well as vulnerable. It's really, really, really sad to see adults that are supposed to be protecting them to actually be causing harm to them or opening them to harm even from a very little age. It is very annoying. It is unacceptable. I watched this video and the man was saying things like, oh yes, I know I've done what is wrong thing to you. Please just forgive me. It's the devil. It is not me. I don't know what came over me. Blah, 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 blah. Most of the time, this is the trend. So what happens is it's all swept under the carpet. No one gets to talk about it. No one gets to know. If not for the social media, I can tell you for free. The social media is what is exposing all these vices in the society out for us to see plain. Because a lot of people have been victims of these things. And it was all swept under the carpet. No one raised any voice. No one said anything about it. And because the people involved had money to pay and shut the mouth of justice, they successfully did. Now it's easy to get more evidence to nail these people down. If you like this type of content and you just like to hear everything I have to say, keep watching. And so if you don't know the story, let me start from the very beginning. So this actress known as Damilola Adekoya, in case you don't know her, she's popularly known as Princess. She had a 14-year-old in her care, which she adopted. She has no child that she allegedly gave birth to, but this is an adopted child, which is her child, definitely. And this 14-year-old was allegedly raped by this actor known as Olanrewaju Omeyinka, something like that. AKA Baba Ijesha. Princess installed CCTV in her home, you know, and that was how this whole thing was revealed. And this man actually had the guts to come into the house where he was assaulting this little girl sexually. The most annoying and painful part of this whole thing is that this has been going on for 7 years. So when this girl was 7 years old, he actually attempted this. And then he felt, probably because she was 14, she was old enough now. Everything don't ripe, baby. Everything don't sit. It's so sad. Children, they are not playthings. They are not toys that you fantasize sexual acts on. He kept on saying, oh, I'm sorry. Let me just kill myself. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Let me just... Like, so annoying. The pain that little child has had to go through, the experience, the torture. Do you know what that lady will be going through in her head for the rest of her life? Anytime she remembers old man like that to a little child. And the annoying thing in Nigeria, the way they make it seem like sexual assault and stuff is just one other thing, it's just one other minor case. So we're getting a small child over sexual assault for like close to 30 minutes, them not doing anything, saying, oh well, it hasn't been proven that he had sex with her. It was just that mere touching. It was just touching her. Excuse me. Even touching her alone should undergo serious punishment for it, so that every other person that is trying it will know the gravity of what they're doing. Boy Ojo came up and she really, the way she took it up, some people will say men all manner of things, that what is it, crying more than the bereaved. Some people will say all manner of things, but yes, I support everything that she did. Reacting to the video and everything she did, I totally support it. Because in Nigeria, most times when we keep quiet about things, the keeping quiet is out of ignorance, lack of exposure, lack of education, integrity. The integrity of the whole country is at stake. People are ready to collect money, and because of chicken change, they're ready to shut their mouth over things that are very much killing our country. Women like this that come out to talk, it is when we come out to talk like this that they begin to look deep into these issues and begin to see the bad in it. But when we keep quiet and we just put it all under the cushion and feel like it's just one other case, it will keep happening. What is the future of our children? Can we be safe to even... It is people like Baba Ijesha that makes it difficult for parents to say, I want to have a lesson teacher, male lesson teacher for my daughter.
Yes, even out of generations that have been even before us and stuff, they will tell you, oh, it was their lesson teacher that disverging them, their lesson teacher was fingering them. And it's real. And most times women, or even these little children, they are being humiliated and they are even oppressed in such a way that they have no choice but to just keep quiet about it, because they see it more like a thing of shame and they make it look like it's all your fault. Even when rape happens, they make it look like it is the woman's fault that she was raped. It is just very sad. These are things that we need to begin to look at. Children are not supposed to be going through this. It is very, very painful. It is very wrong. Please stop the habit of when you are now caught, you now come and be saying, oh, sorry, forgive me, it's the devil. The devil was there, JJ, on his own. You decided to allow the devil to use you. If these people are not caught, they will never even look at what they are doing as wrong. They will keep doing it. It is when they are caught, they now begin to start confessing things like this. The whole senior officer from the Lagos Police Command now had the guts to say, well, the CCTV footage does not necessarily show that he was having sex with this girl. It just shows that he was touching her body. Like, Oga, Shekosi, just imagine if it was your own children that this happened to. Is that the same way? Like the effrontery, the guts. He had to even say that type of thing. He said, well, it's not showing that everything that is on social media, the whole outburst, the whole outrage is all out of sentiments, that people are not looking at it from the place of the law. And I'm like, sir, do you really know the law? Or should we even start from the very beginning? Is the law in Nigeria functional? Is there a law? And are there people above the law? Well, the law needs to be restructured, because I'm not understanding the way he said it. Like, well, there's nothing really to hold the man, so we can't really say there is any state of defilement for a little child. You saw an old man, old enough to be her maybe grandfather, touching her inappropriately, and then you tell me that there is no defilement of any sort. We see these things every day, but it's sad that we can sell our souls, we can sell our conscience just for a piece of cake. We can sell our birthright. We can sell our integrity. Please and please. Like, it is wrong in all ramifications. I feel like they should look into the Nigerian legal system. They really need to look deep into it and know how to restructure the law if the law is not suiting enough to here. Because it's disgraceful. It is shameful. All over the world, they will be watching. The world is watching and they've seen how Nigerians are behaving. I'm wearing this green, white, green to represent Nigeria because I'm everly proud to be a Nigerian. But sometimes some things like this that happen, it makes me wonder why I'm so proud. That's why as parents, we need to be extremely careful with our female children, both the male and the female, because assault is both ways. You can't just leave your child with one uncle or one grown uncle or one grown auntie like that and say you are trusting them. Like the way the world is right now, you can't freaking trust anybody. Well, the wages of sin is death, and I know that there are consequences for this thing. None of you, if you are watching this video and you are that kind of person that you like defiling young children, I'm here to tell you today, you will never go unpunished though. You will never go unpunished, because the consequences, they are there glaring at you. It may not be now. You may feel you are wise, you're smart about it, you're not being caught yet. But trust me, mark the word yet. Because very soon, you will be caught. I'm trying my best not to like go out of proportion. You're me something. On Instagram, that he was now saying his own part, that people should not jump into conclusion, blah, blah, blah. What other evidence are we looking for? I always ask myself, you've seen it. It has been caught on the CCTV camera. This man was touching a girl. A little girl, a minor, 14-year-old, inappropriately. Then you are now saying that people should not be fast to judge. Excuse me, sir. What are we trying to prove? That's my question. Like, continue this in the comment section. Tell me what you think about this whole saga. What is your thoughts? Have you ever experienced or heard any news about someone being defiled? I've heard so many news. Some people talk about lesson teacher. Some people talk about their uncles that they kept in their care. Some people talk, many things are happening.
Thank you guys for watching this video. Please make sure you like, share, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so that you can get notifications anytime I post a new video. I will see you guys in my next video. High five. Thank you. Stay blessed. Bye.